Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, I'm John, this is Many a True Nerd, and welcome back to Civilization 5, where after millennia of living side by side in, if not exactly peace, then at least tolerance, it would appear, finally, Elizabeth said a few too many nasty things to me, in particular the flashpoint that one of her cities expanded to cover my road, cutting off Ionia from the rest of the Empire. That could not be allowed to stand, and now it's time for a war. We are going to take down England today, or die trying. Now, the surplus has pretty much been eaten up by the war, but that's fine. I feel like we've probably got enough troops here to march on London after we're done with Nottingham anyway. As for Canterbury, yeah, they don't seem to be capable of doing much damage to us. I'm gonna send my horses in to finish those guys off. Lovely. And then, yeah, once that's done, you guys can just do a fairly safe attack. Good. Attacking cities. I want to attack anyway. It's going to be fine. So just go in there. They do a bit of damage to us. We do quite a bit of damage to them as well. With reinforcements coming in now together with some more hoplites. I need you to swap places if you can. Thank you. Can you also attack? A costly attack. That's acceptable. I want to attack anyway. Let's just get Canterbury out of the way. They're really not taking that much damage. I feel like Canterbury is going to be a bit screwed. And yes, indeed, I definitely don't really want to go in with cavalry if I can avoid it, because cavalry is not really at home attacking cities. So probably the best thing I can do with the cavalry is, as we've got some cavalry right there anyway, we'll leave that cavalry here, and then, oh, how long have you guys been there? Well, all right, fine, apparently there's just a barbarian encampment. I guess you picked a bad time to spawn in, all right? I've got a really, really big army floating around right now, okay? Now, just in case we run into any trouble whatsoever, I've got more swordsmen coming in and more cavalry momentarily. To be honest, I feel like we probably don't need more troops. Maybe I'll have... Actually, what could Athens do that's better? Honestly, Athens doesn't have any wonders or buildings it desperately needs to get on with. We could have more caravans, though. Yeah, let's get some more caravans going on, sure. If we just kind of run some caravans around them, actually... We're kind of running out of land people to trade with. I'm already trading with my friends down the south. We're now at war with Quebec. Actually, that's a good point. Let's start training a small force to defend Athens, because when the game says we're at war with Quebec, I don't know how seriously Quebec are planning to take that war. Let's get a scout going on who can just march up north and see if he finds any troops whatsoever. Chivalry's done, so obviously that means we now get new stuff. Ooh, banking. Yes, yes, I feel like banking... Banks, all of that good stuff. And more trade routes too. Yes, let's get banking underway. We could actually have this guy over here. You know what? Screw it. Let's just have this guy move in and attack London. Why not? I know, it's a bit wasteful. But I just kind of want him to start doing a bit of damage to London. Just see. Oh, wow. London is really badly defended. I was thinking maybe that defense would count for a little bit more. But no. No, it most certainly does not. London is in terrible, terrible shape. We probably don't even need that flipping catapult. Meanwhile, our warriors can just start heading in this direction and seeing what the Ottomans have planned next. If we find their army, we'll find their target. But I suspect they might be going straight for the flipping capital. Now, Canterbury is going to attack, as is London and Nottingham. But I feel like our forces can easily take what's going on here. We'll make enough money. Ooh, trade ship just showed up there. They gain a little bit of strength back. Tiny bit of damage as well. London's attacking those guys. Yeah, I feel like we got this under control. Let's see what we got here. Yeah, safe attack. Just keep going in. I think we can take Canterbury with just these lads. Oh yeah, Canterbury's going down very, very fast now. I'm just going to have one unit of my... Well, let's just finish off these bastards while we're passing by. You go in there. Those are hand axemen. You go in there. We'll be able to do most of the damage and you'll be able to finish them off. Lovely. Encampment completed, 25 gold, 9 culture. You, however, now head back down. We might want you to help out, theoretically, with... Yeah, that one's getting very, very weak. Can you get over... Head over here. I might need you to relieve that guy. But here's going to be our first victory of the war, I would say. We have definitely got ourselves, yeah, a couple of good units floating around here. Greek bowmen, fire on Nottingham. Lovely, and you also fire on Nottingham. There we are, that's good damage right there. And now just go in, and we should be able to very easily win this one. Attack from the top of the hill. Attack from wherever you are on the plain. And is this going to be enough to win it? Ooh, not sure. But those guys are actually making money, which is nice. And then go in here. Ooh, might just be. You might just be able to win it for us. Nice. All right. So, no need to annex this city. It's kind of terrible. We're just going to create a puppet state. So it will generate gold, science, culture, but you may not choose what it produces. That's fine. It can't produce anything good anyway. I've never been quite sure what the point of raising a city is, by the way. Why would you ever raise something rather than puppeting it? Yeah, screw it. Let's just create the puppet. Lovely. So Nottingham is now a puppet state. Good. That is the first good thing done there. I don't see any realistic chance Hastings is going to contribute anything. So probably at this point, we should just go straight for London. You lot just go into fortify mode. Basically, draw the fire if you can. And other forces just basically start heading in this direction. I think we should be able to, especially with the archers, go over here and take London. I think that's going to be the continent pretty much in our hands. Now, let's get Athens some defense just in case those lads to the north do decide to cause us any trouble, but I don't foresee it happening, really. And oh, I think my companion cavalry have just been brought out of existence because the companion cavalry I was just training has actually shifted automatically into a knight. So sadly, yes, companion cavalry have been rendered utterly obsolete. How very, very sad. Well, that's fine. The knight is a fair bit stronger and he can have his first go out against this little encampment over here. And we've also got a culture policy. Nice. Anything useful I can do here? Ah, purchasing items in cities requires 25% less gold and plus one science from every mint, market, bank, and stock exchange. I probably should have held off buying all those mercenaries until now. Or when it says items, I'm not sure if units do actually count as items. Also, I could have got double the gold from that great merchant. Ooh, that would be worth a lot of money, mind. That would be brilliant. And as people have been telling me to work on completing trees, oh sure, go ahead. Meritocracy, plus one happiness for every city you own connected to the capital. That's plus three happiness. And minus 5% from citizens in non-occupied cities. Well, that's okay. Yeah, that'll be good to get the unhappiness down. Let's go for meritocracy. Potentially even finish off the Liberty Tree. Who knows? Beautiful. Happiness jumps up a fair bit there. Very, very good indeed. The only alternative was rationalism, which does admittedly sound pretty darn good, but I wouldn't mind finishing off the Liberty Tree just for the sake of the happiness thing, because I suspect we're about to bring some new cities into the fold. So making sure that we're kind of set up for a decent wide empire by completing Liberty strikes me as sensible. Though, yeah, just adopting the Liberty Tree for plus 10% science while the empire is happy, that sounds tempting just on its own, yes. Now, Nottingham taken over. Let's see what comes up next here. London presumably is just going to attack those guys down there. That's fine. We need some time to redraw up our troops anyway. Yes, indeed. They finish off that. Do some damage over there as well. That's fine. London, I think, is rapidly running out of time. One unit gets a promotion. Sure, we could... Ooh... Tell you what, I know, like, people really don't seem to like me taking the heals. I don't like taking the heals, especially when we've got this many troops. But, like, this is a basic, crappy mercenary unit. I'd probably rather have it just, like, be healthy and capable of contributing right now. So, most important thing, of course, we need to get our archers into a position where they can start assisting again. So you move over there, but obviously can't attack this turn. You move over here, but can you just start attacking London? Lovely. Aww. That looks like that's going down nice and quickly to me. One of my lovely little mercenaries moves over here. One of you moves over here ready to move in next time. You lot can start moving. Oh, yes, of course. There's roads around here, so it's relatively quickly. Lovely. This area would have been hard to navigate before, conveniently, England built roads to actually flipping assist. Very good. Oh, there's another city up there. I wasn't expecting another city up there. Right, they built York up there. Lovely. Well, you know what? Forget about that for now. Between all of this infantry and these two composite bowmen, I think we can just take the capital right now. In fact, speaking of which, screw it. Let's just go in and do a bit more damage to London. Just to kind of... Like, this unit's almost being sacrificed just to keep London from regenerating. I think it gets 20 hit points back per turn, whereas they can do, like, a little bit over 20. So that just basically stops any of the regeneration effect from actually counting. Nice. Our workers can start moving over to here, ready to start repairing this area once it belongs to me. Because London is the only city in this, basically in this entire empire, that I think is good enough to bother actually annexing and properly bringing into my fold. And if I really want to, I've got enough faith now to buy myself a missionary or an inquisitor. Lovely, used to remove other religions from cities, maybe obtained by purchasing that. Well, I don't really want to dedicate my faith into buying units that are going to convert other people to the, what was it? Was it Christian? Some form of Christianity, Protestantism or Catholicism? I forget which one it is. Yeah, I'm not really sure I necessarily want to do that, to be honest. I think I'm happy with, you know, it should be about the Johnism. I don't want to convert everyone to Protestantism when there's flipping Johnism right over here. Good old Johnism. Is anyone else Johnist? No, not even Johnopolis is Johnist. Well, that's just depressing. Now, we might just be able to take Canterbury as well, but I'll admit it's going to be a bit of a close-run thing. That's going to be... yeah, actually. We might need slightly more strength than I've currently got, but that's fine. We've got more swordsmen coming up right now. And then the hoplites can go in here, and... oh, yeah. I think we're not going to be able to quite take Canterbury. We might not have quite enough strength here, unfortunately. Head in here, keep weakening them. I know horses are not the best at doing this sort of thing, but it will do enough that I believe these swordsmen should be able to just win it, hopefully, anyway. Maybe, just in case, actually, bring you guys back down here. We might need a tiny, tiny bit more strength just to finish the job. All right, the troops assemble close by to London. And, ooh, hello. Open borders with the Ottomans. Sure, why not? Lovely. London's presumably going to start attacking me. York might attack these guys, but that's fine. We're going to have your capital in a second. Hoplites go down. Those guys get attacked. York, yes, indeed, York goes for those guys. I didn't even realize York was going to be bloody up there. Okay, I think we might just be able to take out Canterbury with the units we've got. These cavalry should probably do the job. Yep, take a bit of damage, but that final torch. Canterbury belongs to me. Create a puppet, of course. Lovely. Canterbury and the road to Ionia is now safe and secure. Ionia will be brought back into the trade network. That will solve the problem of the deficit because that will generate a whole bunch more money. Beautiful. The catapult is apparently ready to go. That I'm very, very happy about. In fact, the catapult can just be right flipping here. Oh, that's good. So the catapult can just set up here and just toss rocks over the flipping water. Oh, I'm very happy with that as an idea. You guys and you guys just go for London. Oh, I tell you what, London might fall before the catapults even have a chance to flipping fire. You guys just fortify, because London seems to like tossing rocks at you. So, you know, that's a shame from your point of view. You can move... actually, do I need you to move here? If I move you to here... yeah, you can attack them right now. I know it's a costly attack. London is relatively more defended. Oh, no, sorry. They couldn't quite get there during this turn, I think. That's a shame. So you guys go over here. You guys are full strength, so you can head in immediately. You'll take a bit of damage, but you'll do plenty back as well. You guys just stay back there. And actually, probably move over here and keep an eye on Hastings. Make sure they don't cause any trouble for us. And my workers can just start shoving up improvements in my puppet districts as well. Marvellous. And another great person just got born. Who just got born? Did we get ourselves our first great general there? Great general. Ooh, Belisarius. I like Belisarius. He was part of the Eastern Roman Empire. He's one of the greatest generals that ever lived. He did marvellous work. If you know nothing about Belisarius, the little history YouTube series, Extra Credit, did a really fun series about Justinian that covered Belisarius. Belisarius is really, really cool. I thoroughly recommend that little series. Alright, so what do? You just move around. As I understand it, like, you give combat bonuses to stuff you're standing next to. Alternatively, as a build action, you could construct a citadel, plus 100% defensive strength for any units stored in this tile. Any enemy unit which ends its turn next to the citadel takes 30 damage. Nice. Doesn't stack with other citadels. Constructing the citadel expands your culture borders to surround the citadel. Oh, that's kind of cool. I like that. And will consume this unit. If the new culture border claims hexes already owned by another civilization, you will incur a diplomatic penalty. Oh, so I can literally run my great general into someone else's territory and just say, mine now. That I like. That is really, really, really cool. Okay, so we won't do that right now because obviously it's not an appropriate time to do it, but we will just kind of move you onto a nice high little spot where we can keep an eye on things up here. And actually, yeah, some knights are coming in soon, so you and the knights can go and take over that little bandit encampment. You, Scout, can go up here and basically just stand atop this hill and keep an eye out to see if Quebec's gonna do anything. Hopefully, they won't. Actually, they might not even be coming this way. They could theoretically be sending troops this way to try and relieve Hastings. If so, I think we can probably handle them anyway. And this hero unit has been promoted. Well, that's just lovely. Here you are, Shock Troop 1. Very, very nice. Now, honestly, you probably deserve yourself a nice rest next turn. And even better, we've just actually brought citrus into the Empire, presumably, right? Because we now have that. Do we have the citrus? We might do next turn. We don't yet, but I suspect that citrus, presumably, like, I don't know whether a puppet state's resources count as my luxuries, but we shall see next turn. Now, in terms of Ionia, I think we can definitely get back to more productive stuff than producing catapults. I think the England situation is under control. So, in fact, you guys deserve some culture. Have a library. Very good. Well, no sign of the Ottoman army anywhere around the city they took out, even though they are, yeah, really, really close by to the Shoshone capital. But wherever they're going next, I haven't received any alerts about it, and I can't see the army. Maybe I'll just hang around outside here and just see what happens next. London presumably has more attacking it wants to do, though don't worry, we should now be out of range of York, so now it's just, oh yeah, London really wants those guys dead. London wants these guys over here dead so badly. I can't blame them, those guys did burn down a lot of stuff. Ooh, hello. We must not let war define who we are, the time has come to make peace. I'd say that seems reasonable. So, a peace treaty and also making peace with my allies. Yeah, sure, I think that seems reasonable, why not? So we've, oh, wait, did they just offer me a city? But where's the city? What did they just, what? I just got a city. I'm gonna make it a puppet. But why did they give me, what? What just happened? I just got a free city out of that. Oh, okay. That's great. I didn't really want it, to be honest, but that's fine. What's going on here? Yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna annex it. In fact, let's make it my city. Screw it. Why not? This city is currently, hang on, I need to figure out what's going on in this here city. So this city has a market and that's literally it, I think. Yeah, that appears to be literally all there is in the city. There's just one market, but nothing else. It's actually a relatively wide-bordered city, all things considered. The Turks are just in it, because, wait, hang on. If the Turks are here, that means the Turks just took this city over. But literally just before the Turks were able to take it over, then they basically, the Shoshone decided to hand it over to me instead, because they'd rather I had it than the Ottomans? I guess? This has been a very productive war. As it turns out, I've just flipping got a city out of it. Now, catapult, yes, set yourself up for ranged attack. Lovely. And now, we can do a ranged attack immediately. Oh yes, catapult London. Oh yes, 41 damage. That I like. And then the archers also get involved. This is it. This is the end of you. London. London is just, they didn't even finish off this crappy unit over here. Mercenaries, run in, finish the bloody job. Yeah, one costly attack, but in all fairness, you don't matter because you're mercenaries. You don't even flipping work for me properly. You don't get any health benefits, no dental, no anything. And that's it. London is gonna be mine. In you go, lads. And we are definitely going to annex London. Ooh. It's worth a lot of money. I'm going to say we're going to annex it because of the amount of gold it can generate. You'll receive, a major warmonger penalty if I actually capture the city. Or a, even if I, okay, so if I do literally any, well, I don't actually have a choice because I can't raise it because it's a capital and also a holy city because it's the source of Protestantism. Well, in that case, I may as well annex it, really. It's going to increase unhappiness by 6 or 9. I may as well annex it so I can properly control all the gold inside it. Boom! And now we're to 6 unhappiness. Fortunately, we've got workers nearby who can get working on fixing this place up. Lovely. And a whole load of units just got themselves promotions too. Very good. Though we're not quite done yet. Apparently it's not good enough to take the capital. The capital just moves to York now instead. Oh, blimey. We can actually get within our territory within 2 squares of York. Yes, that strikes me as working very well. And now that we've got flipping these archers and these catapults too, I feel like we should be all right. Hastings is a little bit hard to approach, though, by the way. Forests everywhere, this inconvenient bit of water right here. I tell you what, though, if we set up, like, say, catapult archers, and then just swing in here, we should be able to take out Hastings nice and quick. London's down to, yeah, they're down to two settlements at this point. So I wonder if they'd be willing to lost the will to fight. Elizabeth, you are in no position to talk. With the city you're probably supposed to be sitting in, I just took. You've had to retreat to flipping York. England has lost London. Oh, she doesn't want peace. Well, all right then, you're blatantly losing, but whatever. Now, in London, we should definitely get hold of a courthouse immediately. Yep, get the courthouse underway. It's going to take a while, but normally, like, I don't know why, but when you, like, capture a city, it seems to give you an odd number. It seems to settle down in a turn or two, so that's 100% fine. You need to rest up there. That's fine. A couple of you guys could actually do it. In fact, probably, we should rest up the army just temporarily while we figure out what the next move is. Do you actually also need a courthouse, by the way? You should, get a courthouse first. You get a courthouse before a worker. Let's just make sure we've got some justice going on here. And Elizabeth has lost her original capital. Gorgeous. And city connection between Nottingham and your capital, Athens, has been established. Nice. So we've got a connection to Nottingham and presumably London as... Yep, London as well. London will be connected to my capital momentarily. Very good. Ionia's back as well. So money should start flooding in, which is great. Made peace with Pocatello. This is all good as well. And we've got ourselves a new level of knight. Good. Let's just make you a shock knight. That seems somehow very appropriate. And you can move over here towards these bastards. What are you? You are, oh dear, cavalry. That does not work for you. Great general, go and support these lads, why don't you? Yes, I think this works. Some knights with a great general. That is something you do not want to see thundering down the hill at you. Ah, and Canterbury is apparently not quite in the network by the looks of it. But if we build one road here, we'll link them in. Very, very nice. Good. Well, England's got to be running out of tricks for now. York's got nothing. Like, theoretically, if the capital just moves and the capital gives you +3 defense, we may as well take out Hastings before we bother dealing with York. Meanwhile, every unit in the world apparently got themselves a promotion for taking over a capital. Very, very nice indeed. London and Athens now have a connection. Beautiful. And yes, momentarily Canterbury will as well. Nice. These units need to just rest up for a bit. But as soon as they are back, we'll have some good cavalry again. I could spend some money on 100 gold to make you a knight. Yeah, done. Sure, why not? You can also become a knight. We have got plenty of money for now. So the main thing we're going to be wanting to do is moving our indirect fire units over in this direction to start, yeah, drawing them up outside Hastings. To be honest, I'm not sure we even necessarily need the full army at full strength. I'm going to rest like a significant portion of the army over here, but I feel like, potentially. We've got new swordsmen coming in right now. Are any of you in, like, pretty good shape at least? You're in all right shape, aren't you? Yes, I'd say you probably come over here and my three indirect fire units, including catapults, combined with, yeah, this lad over here, I suspect can just go and take Hastings. It's only 15. Let's just go and smash it. I want England out of this game. They shouldn't have said mean things to me. And in other good news, we can use our workers to repair this area nice and quickly as well. Nice. We've also got a lovely little fortification here, which I do quite like, right at the crossroads between York, Hastings, and London, just to make sure everyone knows, if they're ever travelling between formerly English cities, hey, by the way, the guys who built the massive, terrifying Star Spike Fort, we run this place. Now, actually, I think we've just found what England's problem was all along. Their starting city here, just, even though, like, the Desert Tiles were giving them faith, like, right now, with population 4... I've basically gone for the most fertile squares they had. Actually, we can have that one off and that one on instead. Yeah, I've gone, like, for the most fertile squares they had. A 3 here, a 3 here, a 3 over there, and a 2 up there. And even at 4 citizens, it's going to take them 36 turns for a new citizen. So unless they had, like, some really good other bonuses tied to their religion... In fact, yeah, we know what their bonus tied to religion was. It was connected to the desert faith thing. So this is probably why England struggled. Their capital simply just, like, none of this had any growth. Their capital never grew. That's probably why they were so behind and backwards, because they just didn't have the citizens to support the same growth I had. Poor old England. Well, not a problem anymore. Now they work for me. Now, for these bandits, you, my good man, go and... Why would you not be upset? Why would you not? Okay, go here. All right, now you go here. Now, you guy are now standing next to there. So does that mean, yes, now you can win an absolute decisive victory because the Great General is nearby for plus 15% damage. Marvellous. Though, you do 10% less because the Empire is unhappy. Dear, oh dear. Well, just charge in. Oh, yes, and slaughter them all. Good, good, good. Well done. And finally, we got a hoplite over to this island to see what's in this space we never saw. And as it turns out, Pirate Island just isn't very good. No, it's just not very good at all. I guess you could make a... No, you couldn't make an argument. You could make an argument for over here. You can make an argument for this sort of space. Because you've got, yeah, you've got stone, you've got horses, nearby cattle. You'd be in range of gold mines, more stone up there. You could make a claim for a trading city somewhere around here. That would at least be okay. But other than that, Pirate Island is kind of terrible. Right, everyone starts healing up nice and quickly, of course. Within our own territory, we get bonuses. And, oh dear, I've been denounced by Japan. Well, screw you. You'll pay for this in time, probably. And, ooh, hello, Elizabeth wants peace. Well, that's a shame, because I can't help but notice that apparently you still get 16 gold per turn, but you're not actually offering me, like, any of that lovely, lovely big pile of money. You don't actually have any luxury resources I need. No, sorry, I don't think this ends in peace, to be honest. Maybe... if you'd given us enough giant pile of luxuries, like maybe if you traded away all your money for luxuries I needed with other people you had favours for, and then offered me those luxuries, I'd have been willing to consider it, but for literally nothing, go away. And Canterbury and Athens has also been established as a connection, lovely. Oh yes, the money has started flooding in again, nice. I tell you what I need. I need to start thinking about stuff that generates happiness. Johnopolis, you're right now producing, yeah, aqueducts. Don't do that. Get me a Colosseum going on. Happiness plus two. I need happiness coming into the Empire, please. Now, Catapult moves into position. Lovely. Archers, you, however, will not be able to get into position just yet. That's fine. You hold there for a moment. You guys go up the road here. You can't attack these guys. Just go over here. And then if you can, nope, you're out of move, so you can't go into fortification. That's okay. You guys come just over to, yeah, just over to here is fine. Archers, you move over to this position. And then, yeah, just head down the road next turn. That's 100% fine. Can't attack yet. Yeah, this group altogether should be able to take a strength 15 Hastings, I would say. And then we'll just puppet that. And then England will be very close to being done, especially once all these guys recover a little bit. You just move over here to heal. You'll heal faster inside our own territory. I do find it odd that the Great General can only move two, even though he's like, you know, on a horse and everything. But mysteriously, he can only move two when a group of cavalry with him can go four. That I do find more than a little bit peculiar. Oh, wait a minute. That citrus grove didn't have plantation. Oh! I thought it had the plantation already. Okay, that's just how it looks normally. Okay, so that means we will be able to bring flipping citrus into the Empire. Oh, that's much, much better. Now, Hastings is presumably going to attack my approaching forces, but that's fine. I think we can take that. Hopefully they'll go for these lads, not the catapult at the back. No, they went for the archers, bastards. And Pocatello is surprisingly willing to trade so soon after the war. He wants one of the incenses I've got, and he's willing to offer one gold a turn, and he's also willing to accept an embassy. Sure, why not? I'll accept that. Okay, you set up to fire, and then immediately fire that. Oh, no. You can't. Is this the thing where you can't fire over the woods? Is this gonna... Yep. Well, that's just inconvenient. Right, well, taking Hastings is going to be a lot more tricky then and probably involve a lot of people dying because, yes, the bloody woods in the way mean we aren't actually able to get our kind of siege and range units, but that's fine. We'll be able to get enough units nearby. We can make this work. Right, let's just get some reinforcements moving in just on the off chance they're needed. Right, Hastings is actually going to do an annoyingly large amount of damage to us just by peppering us as we desperately try to get into position because of the woods that it's, providing a really good benefit from, unfortunately. It's going to do a lot of damage to my bloody bowmen as they just try and get into position. Unfortunately, they haven't attacked the catapult yet, and the catapult should do a pretty good job. And meanwhile, a spy has stolen some technology from me. Well, that is a shame. Don't worry about it, though. I'm sure it's okay. Okay, from here, these archers have a shot at least, but I'd like to move them over to here. You over to here, but then you're out of moves, but that's fine. Next turn, you'll be able to start shooting. You can go into ranged attack. Yep, and then just start bombarding Hastings. That's going to do a very healthy amount of damage. You just move around here, and then possibly you can... No, you can't have another turn. And then you move around here. Swordsmen are coming in two. Yes, indeed. Okay, that should be enough troops to clear out this area pretty easily. Hastings is not that tough. And yeah, especially with the catapults, that will go down pretty easily. Okay, Hastings is healing off the damage we've done so far pretty well, but they're not going to do that much longer. Now they're surrounded by units that actually have a shot at them, plus some decent infantry. In fact, actually, I'm not sure they even attacked me this turn for whatever reason. Maybe they're hoping Will and Johnopolis loves the king because the citrus has come into the network. Okay, and that gets the happiness stabilized. Look at all of those luxuries that I'm happy with right there. And speaking of happy with, let's murder English people. Right, there we are. The catapults move in. And these guys attack. And these guys also attack. Oh yeah, that's like half the health bar down in a single go. You guys move in. You guys... Can you guys actually... You guys can't actually get in this turn, that's fine. You guys go in instead. You'll take a bit of damage, but that's fine. I'm loving these mercenaries. I took that kind of culture tech for hiring the mercenary without really knowing what it did. Turns out to have been useful. And we've got swordsmen nearby to reinforce if we need to, but no, they can't really get around there, so we'll just leave them in case this guy dies for whatever reason. But Hastings should very easily go down next turn now. Meanwhile, going against all of the advice I've ever been given in the comments, I've intentionally put both London and... I can't remember, what the bloody city I inherited down here called? Pahokwi, there we are, Pahokwi down here. I've put both of them into stagnation just to get the courthouse done as quickly as possible, because there's few things I consider it's worth going into stagnation for, but I feel like just getting rid of the unhappiness penalties from the courthouse, that's gotta be a priority. So I'll grow these cities after I've got the courthouse done. That feels more important. Okay, everyone arranged properly. Hastings is presumably going to be attacking us, but there's nothing they can do to fight off the inevitable now. They can do a tiny bit of damage to that one unit. No real harm done. We'll pull him back and send in the swordsman instead. Banking is done. Beautiful. Lovely, lovely banking. Ooh, faster movement on road thanks to machinery. Yes, I could definitely do with that, thank you. And Hastings... I think this is over, thank you. We're just going to very quickly finish you off. There we go. Keep on going on. And now we just need to send someone in to mop it up. How about the guy that, yeah, the guy that was attacked. And then, oh, did he just die? No, he did. He got survived. Lovely. He got his revenge. So that's a puppet city, obviously. There we are. Oh, yes, that's impacting unhappiness too. Right, well... The unhappiness will go away in time, I'm sure. Yeah, city residents for 4 turns. I'm sure, like, after that it will calm down a bit. And just in case we need a bit more strength, all of those knights I've trained are now moving up here. Very, very good indeed. Though, to be honest, I'm not really thinking York's going to be able to do much. Though, I will say, looks like there's actually more up here than I was expecting. This land might extend a little bit further than I thought, because it clearly kind of spikes outwards a little bit over there. Intriguing. You're willing to trade horses for cotton? Sorry, no deal. I do kind of need that cotton. It's a luxury I need for my empire. In fact, was that my first? Oh no, sorry, I think that was actually spare cotton, but I'd prefer to actually trade it for, oh dear, we've got a war with, yeah, the Ottomans and the Japanese again. Admittedly, you've done that war before. This has happened in the past. But apparently now it's happening again. Presumably, you're coming from down here up there. And another great prophet in Athens. Lovely. Good old Johnism. Well, I'll tell you what. Let's actually get... Yeah, great person. Move him down over here. Just head over in this direction. We're going to figure out a way to make you turn Johnopolis over to being Johnist. Okay? This is very important. A bank over in Athens strikes me as a good idea as well. We're doing back okay in the money front, even though we're now actually supporting quite a large army, all things considered. And yet more promotions are piling on. Ooh, yes, I'd say accuracy, open terrain. York's in open terrain. Let's get this catapult promoted. Very good. Hastings is straight into the Empire as well. That'll be worth even more gold. Lovely. Someone else built the Leaning Tower of Pisa. No worries. I don't even know what that did exactly. Well, this is the moment. The forces are assembled and York doesn't stand a flipping chance, let's be perfectly honest. So, the catapult moves into the custom house area and gets itself set up, but is out of moves for doing that. Understandable. The other archers are a little bit late, so we're going to have to go and do this on foot. You know, the good old-fashioned traditional way. But that's 100% fine. Let's just get all of our units moving in here. We have got plenty of strength to throw at these lads. So head over here, see what else we've got. Ooh, this is a much bigger area than I was expecting. I'm going to send the knights over here, just for the sake of a little, basically having a little loopsy around. Johnopolis, meanwhile, picked up a Colosseum and is going to take, oh, blimey, 338 turns. Yes, I can see the unhappiness is slowing things down a little bit. I am working on it as quickly as I can. So, great profit. Into Johnopolis you go. While you could create a holy site, I don't want you to do that. Instead, I'd like you to spread the religion. So after this action is performed, 8 citizens will be following Johnism. The majority religion will be Johnism. Kaboom! Johnism 1000. And this city is now properly Johnist. Good. And you're not dead yet. Oh, you can do that multiple times. Okay. I see the advantage of a great prophet in that regard. That's very, very nice indeed. Lovely. Oh no, sorry. Forgot about the great general. He's going to be late to the fight, unfortunately, because he's riding the world's slowest horse. And oh, hello. We've got, oh, just some random Turks shooting some random, oh, you're still at war. Right. Oh, they made peace with me by giving me a city, but they haven't actually made peace with the flipping Ottomans. Okay, so I just basically didn't show up to the war, peaced out of the war early, having taken a city off them, and the Ottomans are still, wow, I was the worst ally ever. In fact, were we even allies? I think we were just friends, and I decided to show up anyway. Belisarius, I've got bad news. I suspect the war's going to be over before you get there. So, just get some fire in there. Oh, 35, that's a good result. Yes, indeed, I'm happy with that. The archers can come in momentarily. Just send you guys in a little bit deeper to figure out what's going on up top of this hill. Oh! We found a new city-state. Hello, you're a religious sort, so they basically increase my faith. Not exactly that useful for me, but all right. They're hostile, they've got horses, they've got gems. Got it. They give me a gift of gold and faith. Find them on a map. There they are. Okay. So this is why, well, partly why England went so bloody harsh on the whole faith thing. Not only did they have the desert thing and thus the desert tiles, they also had a faith-based city-state around the back of them. Well, that all makes a lot more sense now. And my mercenaries just keep on piling in. They're going to take some damage, but let's be clear, they are going to do way more damage to York than they're going to take. In fact, I'm not even sure my archers are going to get there in time. My archers can get up to there eventually. You guys are already injured, so you probably just head over here and rest up for a bit. Yeah, I might be able to get one shot in with these archers over here. The really badly injured group of archers I've left over in Hastings to guard that in case of a possible incursion by Quebec. Meanwhile, I've got visibility of Istanbul thanks to my spy, and in 8 turns he may or may not steal a technology. I think Istanbul is relatively, oh, you've got so much wine. Look at all of the bloody wine you've got. No wonder you're rich and have got loads of troops. That's a lovely starting spot. Yeah, silver and 2 wines, like right where he started. And then flipping loads of fish nearby, stone, cattle, iron. Oh, that is a starting location to flipping die for. And then what did I decide to do? Expand over here. Because he's an idiot. And Pocatello has made his peace with the Ottomans at last. Nice. England's announced it's protecting Geneva. Yeah, good luck with that, England. I bet you've really got the strength to follow up on that threat. Did you manage to get an extra city off them by any chance? No, looks like Pocatello still owns at least something around here. I'm not sure on what basis you came to a peace accord, but yeah, on the bare minimum, they've lost this city and this city to the Ottomans and this city to me, even though I didn't really get involved, so that's good news. Meanwhile, far away, the Globe Theatre has been built. While I've been busy waging war against England, other people have been actually building wonders and stuff. Very, very sad. Oh dear, there's a little English ship over there. Not really that useful in the current environment, sadly. And that gets us a better look over here at Geneva. Pretty standard city-state, good supply of gems, got some knights to defend themselves, but nothing too major. Yeah, unfortunately, England, I think this might just be the end of the line for you. Catapults move in, archers move in as well, and plenty of infantry to seal the deal. And while it's a bit of a costly attack, I'd like the finishing blow to be delivered by my cavalry, please. Just knights charging up the road and murdering York and stabbing Elizabeth. Lovely. In you. They weren't able to win, were they? Good work, knights. I'm so glad I trusted you. And on the plus side, we can go and explore Geneva a little bit more thoroughly, having just tossed them a bit of money just as a gesture of goodwill, because of course, as Greece, I'm just allowed to head into city-state's borders. Very nice. So, York's going to sadly get one more attack in the end. That's fine. We've got plenty of artillery floating around now. There you are. Sadly killed one of my mercenaries, but that's fine. That just means I don't have to pay him. Quite frankly, you're doing me a favour, Elizabeth. Now, just bombard York for a bit. And just keep... I think they're actually out of... Yeah, because they're now down to zero. Meaning now I basically just need to walk in. This is going to cost... Okay, just do it anyway. Charge in. Get flipping Elizabeth.
You have triumphed over us. The day is yours.
Indeed. Oh, she's so sad. She's so sad on her throne. Maybe you shouldn't have said mean things to me. So, Elizabeth, just one last thing. Unfortunately, I'm going to need you to move because that's my chair now. And in we go. Create a puppet. Lovely. That unhappiness will fade pretty quickly. Lots of people get some promotions for that. And that should be the end of England. England is no longer an ally of Quebec. I'm going to be honest, England has bigger problems than that. And that's it. England is no more. All of their cities, in the end, five cities, more than I was expecting actually, have fallen. My mighty army has now gained quite a bit of experience. So if we wanted to, there'd be nothing to stop us heading overseas at this point. We've already accidentally picked up a little bit of a foothold in this continent over here. So I see no reason not to finish off the Shoshone. Then, in all fairness, I never liked the Turks that much anyway. But do we really need to do that? Because something much more important has just happened, which is Delphi just finished its university. So I would say, if we were to buy this tile right here, oh yes, all of this money we've picked up from the war. Yeah, all of this lovely money, all of this lovely science that's just kind of popped up in our empire. I think we can just buy our way to scientific flipping dominance. And I've just spent like literally all of the money. But now, all of a sudden, if I just quickly respec here. Okay, that's maybe a little bit slow. But if I just take off, say, just one of these. Actually, just take off, just lose the faith. We're not using the faith for anything. So that's now slow, but you've already got 13 people. The city's... Ooh, I like the way the city's kind of expanded outwards. That's very, very nice. So that gets our science up to our 150. So, although kind of Delphi is growing slowly... I'd say arguably, you could say that's worth it, because that's just been a 10 to 15% growth across my entire flipping science production, across the entire flipping empire. That I'd say is probably worth it, because I think 13 people is probably enough, to be honest. And yeah, that's science coming up. All of a sudden, everything's just started speeding up quite significantly. So the University of Jungle is coming in. We could probably think about kind of maybe a science victory. We're maybe a little bit behind, but I'd say with Delphi now churning out all of the science, Johnopolis as a center of production, Athens as a nice little cultural center over here as well, together with all of the lovely money that we're going to get out of London once that gets set up. Because, yeah, right now, we're just getting the courthouse done. Soon as the courthouse is flipping done, well, then we can change production back to growth. And once we've got a few more people, we're going to get a lot of gold in here. Like, we're leaving money on the table right now. So we could indeed march our army across the world, or we could indeed try and go for the science victory. It feels like it's probably going to be science backed up by a little bit of military strength at this point. Our peaceful ways have probably come to an end, but I've got to say, Elizabeth I definitely asked for it. She was mean to me long before I was mean to her. And though we're a little bit unhappy at the moment, Quite a lot of that is just coming from... Yeah, 10 of that's coming from occupied cities. We're building the flipping courthouses right now. As soon as those are done, and those will be done very, very soon indeed, that will drop away. We'll be back into happiness. We could build some happy stuff here. Delphi, you could get yourself some flipping... Yeah, Colosseum. Why not get yourself a Colosseum right flipping now? I say that seems like a good idea to me. Once that's all done, we could have a Circus Maximus at Athens. The happiness situation will definitely be under control. We're doing well on culture. We've got plenty of money coming in and plenty more to come once London recovers. So we could go down that route, ladies and gentlemen. But let's be honest, this particular game has had a few missteps in its early stages. I think I've salvaged it pretty well. And we have ended up dominant on this little continent that we live on. That is a very, very good thing indeed. Well, technically, we're still at war with Quebec. We're dominant on this entire continent, with the exception of Quebec, who are still kind of just sitting up there in a corner, shaking their fists angrily at us. But to be honest, I'm not sure Quebec could really do much to me. I think if we wanted to, we could probably go and take out Quebec. I don't even know why they're still at war with me. They were at war with me because they followed England into a war. Like, what the hell do you guys want? England's not around anymore. Oh, right, they were willing to make peace with me. In fact, not only are we not at war, we're now straight up to bloody friends. You know what? I'm going to pledge to protect you. Lovely. And now that I've pledged to protect you, Quebec, that's a lovely city you've got there. But it would be a terrible shame if something were to happen to it. So, peace in our time. Admittedly, peace built on the foundation of the skulls of the English. But that is still peace. That's peace. You can't prove otherwise. And I think, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to leave things off here. Not just for now, but for good, at least for this particular universe. Because, of course, Civilization 6 is now here. And I'd like to move that into the Tuesday and Thursday slots. I've really been enjoying Civ 6. But Civ 5 has been wonderful. I've had a great time playing it. And I've learned a lot about Civilization. And hopefully it's made the Civ 6 series a lot better too. But yes, this is the end of our adventures here with Alexander of the Hellenic Republic of Johnopolis. I think we did pretty well overall, but yeah, we made some really bad missteps in the early game. There's a lot of cities that aren't particularly well placed in particular. Delphi has turned out to be a bit of a scientific blessing, which has been great. Ionia is probably not the best city. But I don't know if this will necessarily be the end of Civ 5 forever, ladies and gentlemen. I suspect one day maybe we shall return. Maybe we shall return when I've, you know, practiced a bit more, learnt a bit more, read up a bit more. Maybe we'll whack the difficulty right up to maximum or something. But we may well be back as well. Though, I do hope you're also joining me on my adventures through Civilization 6, which I think hopefully is a little bit less painful to watch. Because, yes, the amount I've learnt from Civ 5 and the amount I practiced in Civ 6 before we recorded that first series, yes, hopefully that has been a little bit more enjoyable to watch. I do apologize, by the way, to everyone. I understand those of you who are fans of Civilization, I've caused you actual physical pain during this series, so I would like to apologize profusely for that. And may Rome in Civ 6 do just as well, or rather, may it do much, much better. So we may be back one day, ladies and gentlemen, but in the meantime, I've been John, this has been many a true nut, and thank you all so very, very much for joining me on this quick little exploration through Civilization 5. Thank you very much, and goodbye.
What the hell?
Alright, we've now got a Scottish zombie travelling with us. Oh, he's actually quite good now. And he's got over his drinking problem. Which is... Oh, he eats human flesh. He's got some decent carrying capacity. Okay, fine, he eats people. But come on, let's not be flipping judgmental about this.